Here we go.
Jesus loves us.
Jesus loves us.
This I know.
This I know.
For the Bible.
For the Bible.
Tells me so.
Tells me so.
Little ones are.
Little ones are.
To him belong. They are weaker.
They are weaker.
But he is strong.
But he is strong.
J.
J.
E.
E.
S.
S.
U.
U.
S.
S.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Loves us.
Loves us.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Loves us.
Loves us.
Jesus loves us.
Jesus loves us.
This I know.
This I know.
For the Bible.
For the Bible.
Tells us so.
Tells us so.
Little one.
Little one.
To him belong.
Jesus,
Jesus
loves us.
Loves us.
Jesus,
Jesus
loves us.
Loves us.
Welcome back to Day Camp. So glad you're here for Vespers today. Sparky and I are really glad to see you. So I hope you've had a wonderful week with us. We know we've had a great week with you. And I hope you've had fun with rec and arts and crafts and nature and discovery time. And we're going to review just a little bit today with each of our leaders for discovery time. And our chaplains are going to walk us through what we did each day. So Sparky and I will see you at the very end. Bye-bye.
Hi, campers. I'm Aunt Colleen, and I talked to you on Monday of this week. Monday's theme was truth. And if you remember, all week long, we've been talking about the armor of God, all the things that God gives us to wear to protect us in this world. Remember that thing I showed you about the two oranges and how they would float when they had their skin on, but when I peeled one skin off, oh, it sunk right to the bottom of the water. Well, and it's like that with the armor of God. If we don't put these things on, if we neglect these things in our lives won't go as well. And so these are wonderful blessings that God has given us. Now, every day at camp, we did a castle call out, we called it. And every day it was the focus of that day. My day on Monday was the belt of truth. And so truth was the focus. And here's how our castle call out went for Monday. Armor up with truth. And so that was our focus that day. And let me read for you our Bible passage for the belt of truth. This comes from Psalm 86, verse 11. And here's what it says. Teach me your way, O Lord, that I may walk in your truth. How very important truth is. And God has given us the ability to wrap that truth around us like a belt. And as I told you, it's just like God himself through Jesus kind of giving us a great big hug through that belt. So it's a wonderful thing. I hope you've had a wonderful week. And I know I have. It's been so nice to get to know some of you through our little sessions that we've had for snack and for breakout rooms and also for lunch. I've really enjoyed it a lot. And I hope you have a wonderful rest of your summer.
Hey, campers. On Tuesday, we move from the belt of truth to look at the breastplate of justice. And our verse for that day was from Psalm 106, verse 3. Blessed are they who observe justice, who do righteousness at all times. And our castle call out for that day went like this. Armor up, and then remember the scales, with justice. We look together at that fascinating story of David and Goliath. And there are two things I really love about that story. One of them being that David found courage to be a person of justice by remembering God's faithfulness in the past. And David didn't be a person of justice by being someone he was not. Remember putting on King Saul's armor? It didn't fit. David instead relied on the gifts and the talents God uniquely gave him. As people of justice in the world that God invites us to be, I want to challenge you to think about the places, the people, the areas of your life where there's a need for justice. And then also to discover what are the unique gifts and talents God has given you and how can you use them to be a person of justice in the world. Because the truth is God made you and God made everyone special. And you have wonderful gifts and talents that the world needs to help bring justice to make the world more fair, free, open, and balanced. Thanks for being a part of camp this week, and I also hope you have a great rest of your summer.
Hi, campers. I'm Aunt Andrea, and if you recall, on Wednesday, I talked about the shoes of peace. And our castle call out for Wednesday and the shoes of peace was armor up with peace. And then our verse for the day, back on our little lanyards, was peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. John 14:27. And our Bible story of that day was actually the Christmas story. It was the story of Mary and Joseph in all of the chaos of their lives, traveling to Bethlehem, experiencing even more chaos. And then Jesus came, and he was the one who came to bring peace to the world. And this reminds us that our lives get very, very chaotic at times. There's a lot of crazy stuff that happens. But with God's help, we can have peace, and we can help bring peace to the world just by listening to what God wants us to do and following along with it. So if you remember, we talked about the shoes of peace. And at the very end of my teaching, I spoke about walking in someone else's shoes. And what that means is caring for people. And when we care for other people and we listen to the chaos that's in their lives, we can help bring peace to them. And someone who is caring for us can help us have peace too. So that is your blessing and your challenge going forth, is to listen and experience how you can help people be peaceful, and how are those around you who love you helping you with peace in your life.
Armor up with faith. For we live by faith, not by sight. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. On Thursday, we talked about our armor, the shield of faith. Our Bible story was following Jesus after feeding 5,000 people, and then the disciples, Jesus going to a solitary place to pray, following God's call of faith. And the disciples listening and obeying and trusting Jesus in an act of faith to go in a boat on without him. And then a storm coming up and Jesus walking on water out to the disciples. And the disciples saying, oh my gosh, what's going on? Thinking Jesus is a ghost. And Peter saying, if it really is you, Lord, tell me to come to you and I'll walk on water too. And he does for a little while and then he sinks. And we're reminded as Jesus saves him and as Peter gets back in the boat with, and then they're all joined together, surely you are the Son of God. We are armoring up with our faith. What does it mean for our faith to shield us? What does it mean for us to be enfolded in God's love no matter what is happening in the world around us? What does it mean for us to believe in the unseen God? As we think about how our faith is our shield, how the fruits of the Spirit can live and be within us no matter what is happening in the world around us, we are reminded that we have God's shield of faith. I am so glad to be a part of camp this week, even though it's been different. Thank you for being a part of it. And I also want to say thank you for being a part of it, even for those of you that are watching that may not have been at camp this week. And another beautiful thing of doing camp this way is you can watch this video anytime you want, all summer long and even beyond. So I pray that you will continue to think about all these pieces of armor and how God is equipping you to keep growing in your relationship with God and with others and our world.
Hi, campers. I'm Aunt Maddie, and today we wrapped up the week, sadly. This was our last day. We wrapped up the week talking about salvation, which was a big topic to cover. So today, our verse of the day was from Acts 16:31, and it's, believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved. And our castle call out for the day was, armor up with salvation. So the Bible story that we talked about today was from Acts 16, verse 40. And if you remember, it was Paul and Silas, and they were thrown in jail for healing a woman who had a bad spirit inside of her. But they didn't lose their faith, and they sang really loud, and the jail cells opened, and everybody was freed, which caused the jailer to come to Christ, because he said, how do I be saved? How can I be saved? So because Paul and Silas never lost their faith, that brought the jailer and his family to God. And we remember from the example that I brought today about how our life with sin is black and dark and scary. But because God sent his Son to die on our cross for us, that we were washed clean and we're forgiven. God offered us that gift so that when we accept it, we can grow in him. And that is how the jailer, by accepting the gift, the jailer and his family can grow in him and have that eternal life. Okay, so, and to wrap up, I just want to say thank you so much for joining us this year, even though it was a very odd year to be doing camp this way. I'm still so glad that I got to see your beautiful smiling faces, even though it was through a screen. Just remember that you're loved by God and by all of us counselors. We love you. We support you. And please remember to armor up always. So this week we had a verse of the week, and we're going to walk through the motions. We're going to do it all together one last time, and it's going to be the best thing that we do, the best time we do it this entire week. All right? Okay. Be strong in the Lord and in the strength of God's power. And that is Ephesians 6:10. I had to remember the verse.
Lay down.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.